I've always loved music since I was a kid. There was something more visceral about music that could say a lot more than just like being a professor, for example, like, or being an author. You know, there's very special musicians who are able to make a strong statement with their lives, with their sound, with their songs, with all of that. It's just everything that you do, every sound can have a meaning.
We have so many provisions about what we can and can't do, say, can't say, right? Go, can't go. But when the vibrations of music really strike you, then all you have is your imagination and what that music does to it. So you could be 5 years old creating a completely different world inside your head, and that's unique. That's your own footprint on reality.
I was drawn to music at a very young age. I remember I saw the movie La Bamba when I was like 6 years old, and I saw him playing the guitar and singing, and I knew I wanted to play guitar at that moment. I don't know if it was inherent already and that just brought it out of me, but I knew right there. I was like, I gotta be a musician. This is what I wanna do.
I grew up in Colombia listening to different rhythms and music styles, salsa, my mom putting music. I was just being drawn by the rhythm. I know she wanted me probably to be a doctor, but there was something in music, like happiness in music for me.
We love a lot of soul music in Latin America, Mexico, Brazil, all over the world, really. Like the vibe just has, music from the era has that same vibe. And organ, for example, is a big thing, you know, combo organs from that era. Since I bought a Tascam 388, the first beat I recorded on that thing, I was like, man, this is the sound. This sounds like everything I love, you know, 60s, 70s music. It's like, it has that quality to it. That definitely changed my life, along with the synthesizer. I've been collecting those for a while now. I have a few, and I plan to get more.
The first time I bought a recording unit, guitar center, no doubt. And Fostex MR8, a red one. It was a multi-track. And I could take it anywhere with my friends playing music and put mics up and record and take it home and mix it and bounce it to a CD. And now there's a recorded history about where you were at a certain time in your life, you know, who you were with and what it sounded like. That's history. My uncle's SG bass, EB3, from 1972, had been in the closet for years, just like cheap old bass, just all dusty, dirty. And then I brought it to the band because this is the next bass I had, and it just dictated the rest of how I would play bass up until now.
I remember at school, they had the marching band, and I start playing the snare drum and just like practicing every day. Just move the head, play the side, the rim shot. I start getting into that, like, there's no limit. Just by playing the snare, you can just express yourself.
Fender Stratocaster, it's just one of those guitars that you can make any sound come out of it. And there's a lot of liberation with the vibrato system. Try to find a space where I could just slightly bend, you know, a chord here or there. And probably when we were starting out, there wasn't probably many bands using like wah-wah, right? Like a crybaby, very much. And it just brings like a funky sound that just, I think, is a big part of the band too. You're along for the
ride. I took a movie class, right? We're watching films from like the 60s, 70s, you know, just artsy films, right? I remember this one film called The Perfume Nightmare. It's Filipino flick. It was super psychedelic, super trippy, and just kind of like, just super weird. So I guess that was kind of like where Chicano Batman came from. You know, it's both literal and not literal at the same time. It could be like, yes, I'm Chicano and this is who I am and I'm a hero as well. But it's also like, this is just a cool combination of two things, regardless of what those things are. You know what I'm saying? It's a culture and it's pop culture combined, because this is everybody's state. So yeah, it was just kind of like a heady name to throw out there and just kind of like have people just interpret it however they want. And obviously interpretations run the gamut. And that's cool, and that's all right.
I'd say our music like helps fill like a kind of a void that you have in popular American music right now. It's unintentional, but it's intentional, I guess, at the same time. I think the more that there's more diverse acts, the better everyone is for it.
You know, while politics want to build borders, you know, music destructs them. And you see that, like when you're playing and people's eyes, you know, and the reaction.
Everybody's singing the songs no matter where they're from, too.
Yeah. with music, if you take a risk, I think you also set an example for those who also want to take risk. That's big. That's big because taking risk means thinking outside the box. It means getting outside of your own perspectives of life, you know, letting in new ideologies, just operating without fear, without the idea that you're gonna be judged differently, you know. You realize that there's a ton of people out there that are just like you.